Hey, this is Rebecca Dirks with PremierGuitar.com. We're here right across the street from Wrigley Field in Chicago with
right across the street. It's pretty awesome.
This is Satchel from Steel Panther, and they rock. So we're going to hear...
We do rock. And you know what? She's never even seen us play, and she knows that we rock. Just through the grapevine, she's heard...
I've watched videos.
The videos are cool, but I mean, the live experience...
Let's start by talking about what guitars you play.
Shut up.
I hear you also play rhythm guitar.
I do. I play rhythm, what he said. I play rhythm guitar, lead and rhythm. And all the bitchin' sounding guitars that you hear on the record are pretty much for me. Except on our new record, Nuno Betancourt did actually do one solo.
Which song?
Ripping on a song called "They Won't Suck Itself."
Oh, that was one of my favorites.
You like that one? That's one of the best solos on there, huh?
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't like that much better than.
Good, thank you.
Any of the other ones.
Mine are like you know, I don't have to like shred and just show off all the time. Not that Nuno does, but he's pretty fast. But he's rad, dude.
All right. Well,
and you know what we gave him for playing on a record? We let him have sex with one of our groupies for free.
Only one.
Well, yeah.
Not 17.
Well, yeah, there was that was a reference to a song called 17 Girls in a Row, which I wrote after one of my own personal experiences. And, you know, I'm sure if you've seen any other interviews with like our singer's over there, he's like trying to learn how to read right now. He's reading some Dr. Seuss. And he says that he wrote the song, but actually I wrote it. It's about some girls that I had sex with. So it's pretty bitching. I know.
That was really generous of you to
thank you.
Share with
you. Welcome. I'm a generous guy. I'm a giver. You know what I mean? That's how I feel with my solos. Like, just when you think, it's like, there's not another bitchin' note that guy could hit in that solo. I hit, like, that one last, like, suspended second note over the right bitchin' chord, and you just go, okay.
So we're actually kind of here to talk about your gear.
My gear?
Well.
Oh, my guitars.
Your guitars.
But she was getting fresh with me.
What are you playing here?
What am I playing right here? Well, this is a vintage 1957. Well, no, it's not actually that old. It's a Kramer Pacer. This is like, it's probably like stock. I mean, you know what? I don't really know that much about my guitars. I just know how to play them. Like, my vibrato is totally rad. And like, you know, I can stretch my fingers from like the 24th fret to like the 3rd fret. I'm not going to do it right now because I'm not warmed up. All the guitars I play with Steel Panther are Kramer Pacers, and they just, they're bitching. They stay in tune and they rock, and the action is really low. Look at the action right here. Check this out. Look at this. See how low that action is? You could probably, I mean, look at that. Isn't that insane? Doesn't that just make you, it makes you horny, kind of. It might be Rebecca, I don't know. But let me tell you, that is some low action right there. It's, nobody wants to like run the hurdles. If I wanted to do that, I would have stayed in gym class, you know? So the action's low, the frets are pretty big, you know, and I got two, like, these are Seymour Duncan pickups right here. You know what those are, right? Pickups.
Yeah, of course I know what those are. They're humbuckers.
And it's got this is known in the heavy metal industry as a whammy bar. I used to call it a wang bar. I think some people call it like a tremolo system. See, you can do this with it. A lot of kids don't do this these days, but you can push it all the way down and make it go like that. And then when you let it back up, it's still perfectly in tune. Ooh, that's not so good.
You did just get off a plane with it. Okay.
Yes, you know what? And I put it in the overheads. And then there was this other person. They came in with like their bowling ball, like a prized possession, and they shoved it into my guitar, and I was this close to like kicking this guy's ass on the plane. But he was like really tall. He was like 6'8", right? You know, like 450 pounds. And
you don't want to f*** with that.
No, I, well, you know, the thing is, it's I'm bigger than that. I don't like to fight people, just, you know, to like prove a point.
What amp do you plug this into?
Ah, that's a, you know what? That is the best question you've asked so far, Rebecca. I plug this into whatever amp is at the gig. No, I play a, you know what? Right now, I've been playing the new EVH amps. Have you heard of those? Oh, my God. Bitchin'.
The 100-watt head?
It's kind of mumbled the F word. You're going to have to cut that out.
We'll bleep it.
Yeah, because there's like little kids and stuff.
Actually, I said it earlier too.
Because those kids need to know that they need to know like the F word and shit. Bleep, you know, you can bleep it if you want, but these kids, I'm telling you, man, there's not a 7 year old in America that doesn't know all those words already. And they hide it from their parents and stuff. That's how I was when I was a kid. You know.
You turned out great.
Got into my dad's Coke drawer and snort all the Coke in his drawer. This is probably gonna get edited too, but whatever.
Back to the amp. I'm sorry. Is it the 100 watt head, or they just came out with a 50?
100 watts. They did? God, you know, I don't even look at the 50 watts because I need more power than that. Sometimes I'll stack, like, I'll run like 6 or 7 100 watt heads in tandem, and just like the power just builds. I don't know how electronics work, but it gets so loud. That's the kind of power I need, because I really need to be loud, because our bass player hits a lot of bad notes. So I try to cover up his sound with my wall of sound. And that way, if there's a bad bass note, it's like you can barely tell. Like, what's that funny noise underneath the bitching guitar sound? But yeah, 100 watts.
Pretty inspired by EVH then.
Oh, yeah.
Big inspiration in your life.
It's like it's fat, it's got bitching low end, you know, and I like my low end tight, you know. Ask Rebecca, she knows about that. I like those. What? I'm talking about the sound, Rebecca. The low end on these amps, it's like super tight and like just, ugh. Just want to reach out and squeeze it, you know? That's how tight it is, the low end. Yes, you squeeze it. And it reaches out and grabs you by the balls if your balls are out, like our new record that just came out, Balls Out. That's what we're talking about.
Nice plug.
And yeah, it was a good plug, wasn't it? Subtle. So we like that tight low end to make you, to grab your balls and just rip them right off of your body. Ooh, that sounds terrible.
What kind of speakers do you have in the cabinet?
I'm pretty sure there's Celestians, but I could be wrong. You know, I don't really look in there. I just know I plug it in, and if it sounds bitchin', I roll with it. You know, it's kind of like these pickups. I know there's Seymour Duncans, but I didn't ask the people at Kramer. I said, surprise me, you know? Kind of like, you know, when I'm at a party and I have sex with a girl. I just like go, we turn the lights off. I'm like, do what you're gonna do. And sometimes it's, you know, when the lights go back on, you're like, whoa, I didn't even know that was going to happen. But it's still a good time when it's going down, you know what I'm saying?
You're using wireless units?
Yes, I do. I use a wireless unit. See, that's a wireless unit right there. Plugs into my guitar.
A line 6?
Right. It is a line 6, that one.
Relay?
I don't really know. It cost me money, though. I know I didn't get it for free. But it's killer. It works. And sometimes it doesn't work, and sometimes it does. But when it does work, it sounds bitchin'.
But it lets you run around stage.
Yes, yeah. I do. I run around. You've never seen us live, but I do run around quite a bit on stage, and I jump over things. Like, our singer is quite slow and slightly overweight, so sometimes I'll just jump over him. Like, I'll jump over him before he even knows I'm doing it. I'm, like, over him, and I'm at the next microphone singing backgrounds and shit, and he's like, whoa, what happened, you know? But and he's pretty tall too. Like, he's about my height. I'm about 6'4", and from the stage, I look 6'4". Okay.
So you talked about how you like the action really low. Do you have any specific string gauges you like on this?
Well, you know what? I play 9 through 42. It's 9, 11. Wait, 9, 11, 13. What is it? 9. Wait,
9. 42.
Yeah, you know. I don't know. All I know is they're kind of bendy.
And.
Yeah, this is like 9 through 42, but if I'm doing like just rhythms, like on for the record, for instance, I'll put like 10s or 11s on, you know, it's just so I can like hit them a little bit harder and it doesn't get quite out of tune. You know what? But live, it's like it's gonna be so out of tune anyway because our singer just really can't hold the note anymore. So the more out of tune I am, you know, the more it sounds good with the singer, which is kind of how Led Zeppelin did it, I think, right? Yeah.
What kind of pick are you using?
Ooh, that's a really good question. That is that's my own pick, right? I made it from scratch.
Really?
No. I paid for somebody to make it from scratch. It's made out of actual tortoise. They had to import tortoises from the Galapagos Islands.
A blue tortoise.
It's a blue tortoise. Well, it's... Rebecca, don't be silly, Rebecca. It's not a blue tortoise. It was a real tortoise, but I dyed it blue. It's Tortex.
You like that?
I don't know what that's really made out of. I don't know the scientific term for it. It's not really a tortoise or a turtle or a turtle, for that matter.
Like,
but it feels good. Feels sexy in my hands.
Tip.
I do. I file my picks down, and that when you really want to shred and you're on stage, and you see like some super hot chick like Rebecca out in the front row, and you're like, I want to play super fast, so she like thinks I'm totally bitching. That's the way to do it. You shred, you file it down, because if you don't file it down, it's like playing with like a tree stump. It's like really hard to go fast, but you file it down and way easier to go fast. The hard part is just syncing your left and right hand, which is, when it's super loud, it doesn't really matter anyway.
Do you use any pedals or effects?
I, you know what? I don't, on the first record that we did, our old record, which is like super old now, that's called Feel the Steel, by the way, by Steel Panther. Go steal it online. That record, I didn't really use any effects on any of the solos because the solos were so bitching. But this record, the solos needed a little help. I'm just kidding. But I did use a wah-wah on some of the songs, like two or three of the songs. So now I have to carry a damn wah-wah pedal with me.
Just your regular Crybaby?
Yeah. Well, no. Actually, I think I used a Vox. A Vox wah. Have you ever tried those? You like those, don't you?
So that's the only effect you're really using.
Well,
I feel
like reverb on it, I think. not really much else.
I feel like guys, you know.
Tuner. I have a tuner pedal.
A lot of guys play your genre of music like to have, like big racks and stuff.
A lot of people use effects, and a lot of guitar players. I'm not really a gear guy. I'm a pretty simple guy when it comes to gear for a couple reasons. Number one is all those pedals cost money. So every time you lose a pedal, you got to replace it. I hate that. Right. And plus, if you start doing what I just did on the new record, I used a wah-wah pedal on the record. Right. So now I got to carry the damn thing with me everywhere I go just to make that wah-wah sound. So which is cool. But, you know, you start adding more effects. And then before you know it, you got like a refrigerator behind you with all your effects and like three guys that you had to hire just to switch in between effects like during the show. You know, and I'm not the Edge from you too. Okay. Who am I? I'm Satchel.
So there's that one song, I think is it. It's If You Really, Really Love Me. Is that what it's called?
If You Really, Really Love Me, yes. Yeah.
Now that starts with an acoustic, right?
What were you playing? It starts with an acoustic. I played you know what? I borrowed a guitar. It was a Gibson acoustic from a guy named Matt Nelson. Do you remember the band Nelson?
Oh, yeah.
You do?
Well, no, not remember, like from my own life, but I'm aware of.
Yes, her dad has the record, the Nelson record. So yeah, but Matt Nelson, who is awesome and a totally rad musician, he let me borrow his guitar and it sounds awesome. Actually, I borrowed that guitar for our first record too and used it on Community Property and a timeless classic song called Girl from Oklahoma. Have you heard that one?
I haven't.
Oh my God, that's a great song. That's a great song. You should go listen to it.
I will.
You should. Listen to it while you go to sleep tonight. It'll put you in a good mood.
Okay. Well, thank you for taking some time to talk to us. I think that you're really needed downstairs. They're probably, yeah.
Okay. Well, I love you guys, and thanks for playing guitar. And, you know, remember, it's a great instrument. And even though you probably suck right now, you're going to get better if you practice.
And then what?
And then eventually you'll be a big boy, and your parents will probably make you move out of the house and get a real job, and you'll probably get, if you're smart, you'll say, I'm not getting a job. I am going to play guitar and I'm going to go rock for a living, and you will go and find a stripper to live with who will support you while you do this, and things will look up from there. You'll be on your way to the top of the rock and roll heap. The camera's not even on. I don't see a red light on that. Oh, yeah, there it is.
All right. I think that about does it. Thank you very much for taking some time to talk to us. Oh, we're shaking hands.
Thanks, guys. Woo! I love you. Oh, this mic's still on. I'm sorry.
There's an outro that I do.
Oh, you do an outro?
Yeah.
Okay, Rebecca's going to do the outro right now.
This is Rebecca Dirks for PremierGuitar.com.